Good morning, everyone. So as we are over here for this conference, and we are here to address this specific issue of rural challenges and opportunities, I will be talking about solid waste management as one of the challenge which our cities are dealing with for last couple of years, and it will be one of the biggest challenge in coming years. I am representing an organization called Paryavaran Mitr, based in Gandhi Ashram, Ahmedabad. The idea is, when I say Paryavaran Mitr, I am trying to talk about these women who are going on roads and collecting waste from our streets, the littered streets of India, because they see value in it and it is their bread and butter. First question is, why the name Paryavaran Mitr? Talking about Jaipur, 30,000 such women are there who are going very early in the morning. Reason for going so early in the morning is, at that point of time, streets are empty, so they can travel maximum distance in minimum time, therefore maximum collection. Secondly, rag pickers are not considered as a very good job, you know. So it is considered as a menial job, so they want to avoid human interaction. So at that point of time, early morning, hardly anyone is there on the roads. So 30,000 women will go very early in the morning, travel 8 to 10 kilometers, bend at least 1,000 times, and then they will collect 20 kgs of recyclables. 30,000 women, 20 kgs of recyclables, 6 lakh kgs of waste is picked up every day from streets of Jaipur. So we believe that they are doing such a phenomenal service by keeping our city neat and clean, by contributing to Mother Earth. Because of them, this 6 lakh kgs of waste is reaching to recycling unit, which otherwise would have been reaching to dumping yards, and it would have taken centuries to decay. And that's why we call them that you are not a rag picker, you are an honorable Paryavaran Mitr, you are a friend of environment. So being a business graduate, the model which we have taken up is not charity based, it's a business model where we are using solid waste management as a tool to holistically empower these wonderful souls. So today, when we talk about solid waste management, there are three main stakeholders from our point of view. One is, of course, government, municipality, municipal corporations. Second is our respected sisters, Paryavaran Mitr, and household. Like any government institution, if we want to get some work done, of course, we will want that minimum investment is there in that whole model. It should be efficient and hassle-free. For our Paryavaran Mitr sisters, they want that the model should take them into consideration. It should be inclusive. The employability should not be gone. It should not be like machines are coming and taking care of everything. So if that happens, 30,000 women will be unemployed in Jaipur itself. There are nearly 2.5 million people in India who are into profession of rag picking. Respect and recognition is missing because it is considered very, very menial job. So once they will get into the formal sector, they will have a nice uniform with good identity card. So that is the expectation of Paryavaran Mitras. And third is household. They just want that waste should be properly picked up from our houses in an economical manner, in an efficient manner. So a holistic approach needs to be planned, wherein every stakeholder is given whatever they expect from the system. It cannot be concentrated only one factor. It cannot be concentrated on only one aspect of the whole problem. So what we are doing in Ahmedabad is very simple. Like, we have taken a ward with the government. Suppose 1 lakh people are living in that ward, nearly 20,000 families are there. So 500 sisters will be going to these 20,000 families. One sister will go to 40 houses. So what will happen? These 40 houses will be giving their segregated waste to the Paryavaran Mitra ladies. in a month, if once we go to the report part or research part, in a month normally one household will give this lady 5 kgs of recyclables. So 40 households are there for one lady, so 200 kgs of recyclables they will get, which will roughly give her 2000 rupees money when she will sell it to Kabadiwala. Secondly, as a service charge, even if we are taking 50 rupees per month from one each of the household, for 40 household she will be getting 15 to 42,000 rupees again as a service charge. So the lady who will be going with a nice uniform into the societies for collecting waste from 40 households will be earning 2000 rupees by selling the material which they will get, and 2000 rupees out of the service which they are providing to the societies. So 4000 rupees per month by doing 3 to 4 hours of morning job, and afternoon they can again work on some alternative resource. So that way the expectation of a rag picker, that way the expectation of Paryavaran Mitra sisters will be taken care. Coming to government side, since each of these sisters are earning by their work itself, government don't have to pay to them. It will be zero investment from government side. Only the infrastructure needed will be a truck which can collect all this waste along with sisters. More and more employability can be shown from the government side, like 30,000 sisters are still employed. They are not going, you know, unemployed due to the advent of the model. Thirdly, it will be, as it is rightly said, no extra investment, more employability, plus hassle-free. More and more sisters will be included. Every sister will be going to household because they will be getting recyclables as well. The currently the problem is team is going, but they are getting mixed waste. And mixed waste is not at all useful, because once it is mixed dry and waste, recycling cannot happen. Or even if it is happening, the only small portion can happen. So once this linkage can happen on the backward side, it will ensure that door-to-door collection is done without doing any extra investment, without unemploying millions of women in our country and any developing country for that matter. On the forward linkage side, when we were doing the research of this whole project, we realized that once they are done with collection on road, they will have a big bag, you might have seen. They will collect whatever they find useful, paper, plastic, iron. They will go back to their homes and start the process of sorting paper separately, plastic separately, iron separately, because different things have different monetary worth. Then they will be selling this collection to Kabadiwala, Pithawala. And this is the place where she is exploited like anything. Means a sister is coming with 20 kgs of waste. The weighing machine will show 16 kgs, 18 kgs, 19 kgs, depending on how corrupt, how exploitative the person is. All of these women have taken some kind of loan. So if the market rate is 10 rupees per kg, she will be offered 6 rupees, 7 rupees, 8 rupees. So as a model, it was very evident that if we want to bring some meaningful change which is long lasting, we have to get into the business of kabadi shop. We have to make our hands dirty. So as a model, what we did, first we opened a center of this space where any sister, after coming from waste collection on road, can come over here, do the process of sorting over there, so that their houses are neat and clean. Their houses are normally half of this size of this platform. So doing that process of sorting is really unhygienic. Kitchen is there, kids are playing there. So this facility is made for that purpose. They will go over there, do the process of sorting, and then they will sell it to whomsoever they want, not necessarily us. That way the purity of our home, purity of that lady is maintained. Washrooms are made, music systems are installed so that they can enjoy the work. Once they are done with selling at kabadi shop, they can get freshen up, and then they can go back to their homes the way they have started early morning. Second intervention which we did is, we have opened our own kabadi shop, because as I shared earlier, kabadi shop is the place where she is exploited like anything. So as soon as we opened this shop, that journey of that lady who was getting 17 kgs into 7 rupees, 119 rupees, she starts getting 20 kgs full plus 10 rupees actual market value, 200 rupees. So in the graph, it can be shown that nearly 70% increase in income is there, doing nothing but running that kabadi shop with purity and honesty. Second thing is, like in any other business, volume is a parameter. Like we are working with, say, 200 sisters, each of them bringing 15 kgs of waste or 20 kgs of waste. Every day, 3,000 kgs of waste is reaching to the unit of Paryavaran Mitra. That enables us to sell it directly to recyclers, bypassing dealers and distributors. So again, even if these two stakeholders were earning 2 rupees per kg extra, that 4 rupees comes to the organization. And being a non-profit, that money is again trickled back to the women who are working on ground. So another 20 into 2 rupees because of the profit that is made in this business. So a lady who was earlier earning 17 into 7, 119 rupees, now she is earning nearly 240 rupees, 220 rupees, nearly twice of what she was earning before. But since the organization's vision is not to do solid waste management, our first and foremost vision was to bring that respect, bring that dignity to these women. In Gandhi Ashram, we follow this philosophy that we cannot do great things, we can do small things with great love, which Mother Teresa said. And if we are doing this, automatically the expansion and everything will take care. So as far as respect is concerned, very small gestures we are trying to follow. Like whenever a sister is coming with the waste, once the business transaction is over, she is offered a cup of milk. That small cup of milk will not change the health drastically, but it is a gesture to say that we appreciate your work and you are integral part of our society. You are not untouchable or you are not doing a menial job. You are doing a very, very important job. These sisters are going to different offices, institutions, schools, and this is a picture of Kamla Ben sharing her journey in TCS. So for someone like us, it is very easy to get an opportunity to share their journey with the educated people of our society. But for someone like Kamla Ben, who was living in a house half of this size, who was never allowed to be said, if she is sharing her journey with 70, 80 professionals in a good company, that experience, that 30 minutes of session recharges them, give them confidence for at least 6 months. So these are the small things which are being done in order to do the social upliftment aspect of the project. These many of the volunteers, being in Gandhi Ashram, we are blessed to have many volunteers. These are the volunteers from Teach for India. They are coming every year over there, sitting with our sisters, doing the process of sorting, so that they can understand that what are the hardships involved in waste collection and waste management. Because if we will just work on one layer up, if we will not be working as kabadi wala, if we will be working as dealer, life will be very, very easy. Number of transactions will be very less. The dealing will not be with every day with 200 sisters, 300 sisters. But working at this level, the level of the kind of challenges are different. Somebody will be in bad mood and she will come and scold you, indifferent of what you are, you know, your organization. For 2 rupees, they will come and, you know, start fighting with you. So those are the challenges which we have to overcome in order to bring some change on ground level, which was not the case if you would have worked at distributor level or recycler level, which many of the good organizations are working on. If any volunteers are coming to serve in Gandhi Ashram in this project for more than 1 month, first thing which they have to do is to go and rack pick, because then only they will understand that for whom they are working, what is the purpose of their journey of service. So this is the thing which I did after graduating from IRMA for 3 days, because our mentor in Manav Sadhana said that you have to understand this before you design a model. So this kind of experience leaves a long-lasting impact, whether that volunteer is doing something or not in her or his future life, it doesn't matter, but it is an experience that remains with the person for a long time. And when a lady leading these 3 people for a single night, again, that experience gave them a lot of confidence that some segment of our society still cares for us, still try to learn from us what we are doing and why we are doing. Of course, health. Since we are dealing with waste, most of the sisters are going on roads with naked hand, putting their hands in different places, dustbins, public holes, wherever they feel that some kind of waste they can get. Health is a very, very big issue. Skin problems are there, respiratory problems are there. They are carrying 20 kgs of waste for 10 kilometers. Body ache is there. So health is a major part of the holistic development which we are trying to address. So health can be improved, means some campaigns has to be done, but only campaigns will not work. Actual camps we are putting in, where level one category of problems will be tackled then and there itself. Doctors will be coming, examining the sisters, and whatever is the problem, they will be giving medicine. And then on the top of it, if some of the sisters need some specific kind of surgery, specific kind of treatment, that is done by the medical team. On the basis of card she has, on the basis of resources we have, on the basis of genuineness and the priority, we can see. Because as an organization, we cannot address everything in one go. This is one of a flagship event, Saturday special. As I shared earlier, these are the women who are not heard any time. They didn't had any opportunity to take out the negativity which they had or anything which they want to share. For a slum community, they are just treated as a commodity. Very sad to say, but this is the harsh reality. So this program was envisioned to give them 2 hours of free time every Saturday, where they will come, they will have a fun-filled 2 hours of event, do some basic garba or play some dumb charades. Idea is to give them a platform for sharing, where they can talk about some positive things happening in their life, where they can talk about some negative things happening in their life. After effect of these kind of small sessions are, if in the evening or later in the evening, some kind of basic level of domestic violence is happening, since the bonding between each of these sisters have been increasing with each of these events, 4 or 5 sisters can come together and stop that. I'm not talking about high level of domestic violence or very serious domestic violence, but basic things can be tackled. And community bonding is the thing which we all look forward to as a non-profit. Secondly, since we are working with these sisters, idea is to make them friends. Because unless we are friends, like this sister in the middle is Veena Ban, she is coordinator of one of our centers. Her main job is definitely to take care of the whole financials of the center. But along with that, she has to talk to each and every sister whenever she is coming with the West, that if she has any problem at personal level, family level, or societal level. Because unless we know the problem, we cannot address it. Unless that lady don't see a friend in us, she won't open up. And unless she won't open up, there is no meaning, or the engagement will be very superficial. So once that bond is created, once she starts to see a friend in us, then our job is done. Because then they start sharing their problems, their dreams, their aspirations. And then as an organization, we can address them in a planned and systematic manner. Many volunteers are coming and sharing their skills, whatever they have, whether it's meditation, yoga, or something. Meal is a very important aspect of any event, because the community with which we deal, getting a good quality meal at any point of time is a blessing. So irrespective of whatever what the event is, what is the agenda of the event, meal will be the point of closing for any of these event. So I will be concluding it, this presentation. The idea is lots of models are being made. Lots of models will be made, and it will definitely take some effort, but an inclusive model can be made, which will not be disturbing the life of the most deserving candidates. When I talk about solid waste management, 80% of the work is done by these sisters, because they are the one who are bringing waste from road to a kabadi shop like us. What we are doing is just facilitating, just trading. So unless 80% of the pie will not go to these people, it won't be fun. You know, like we say that we are the one who do the work and somebody else churn out the profits. So this model will be completed when we will be having 5 such kabadi shops, and then our own processing unit. Because the dream is to do everything from rack picking to processing in-house, and they are the owners, we are just the facilitators. So in this model also, since it is a business, we are buying from sisters and selling it to recyclers. Whatever profit is being made, that profit is shared on a quarterly basis with these women in terms of grocery, in terms of education fee, in terms of medical treatment. And that profit is shared in terms of the business they have given to it. It's not equal. The softwares are there which record each and every transaction. So a lady who has given more waste, she will be given more profit. So idea is to slowly convert it into a cooperative kind of model where they will be the one who will be running the show and we will be just there to facilitate them. So here I will end. And this is the, of course, being working in Gandhi Ashram, this is what we believe in, that whatever small or big things we want to change around us, we have to practice it within us first. Thank you so much.